Hey, class, I want to make a short video just to help show you how to graph your information. So this is our golf ball lab, and you can use a different kind of ball if you need to. Any kind of little ball that'll bounce. Don't use a bowling ball or something crazy like that, but your mom probably won't be very happy with you. But drop it from different heights. We're seeing how high it bounces back up, right? Do that three times each height, kind of get an average. So not too bad to go through that, and then there's some questions to answer. I always want to show you how to make a good graph. So I'm using Excel Online. I like the full version on my computer better, but I'm just using this because everybody can access it. You could also use like Google Sheets. You could just even search online for, graphing software, and there's all kinds of places you could make a graph. But Excel is a really powerful one, and so I would encourage you just make some little data table. Looks like this: bounce height versus drop height. Put your drop heights in, and then average bounce height. So you did have three drops from each height, but we just want the average. That's what we're going to graph. And so I want to show you how easy it is to create it. So once I've made this data table, then I can just highlight it and click insert. And then there's a lot of different graphs. Now we want a scatter plot. That's an XY. That's relating two different variables. And I'm going to choose this one that connects points. And you can move it around. You can click it and resize. You can do all kinds of things with it. And so what I want to show, let's add a couple things. Okay, so for a graph, we need to make sure that our axes are labeled. Because if someone just looks at this, they don't know what these numbers represent. And so let me show you a way that we can do that pretty easily. So up here, chart title. And so we've already got a title there. That's why I typed this here. So that's okay. That is the title. We want that. Legend, that's this thing down here. We don't need that. So I'm going to get rid of it. But we want axis titles. So that's our x-axis, our y-axis. So for axis titles, our horizontal, that's our x-axis. And let's call that drop height. And let's include the unit. So the idea is someone comes in and they don't see your data table over here. They should be able to look at the graph and know what they're looking at. Okay? So that's why these labels are so important. And now let's go label the other one. So axis, my vertical one. And there's different options for how you do it. I'll just do a horizontal label. So this is average bounce height. And again, I'm going to include the units there as well. Ooh, I got my caps lock hit there accidentally. Let me try that again. Average bounce height, that looks better, in centimeters. Okay, so there it shows up. So there's a nice graph. You can click off it. And again, you can resize, do different things with it. There's a lot of options, but I just want to show you how to create one. Now, when you need to go load this in, you could use like if you're on a computer, you could use a snipping tool and just copy that image, insert that to show me that you made a graph. I mean, there's different ways you could clip that and upload it into the Kinexis when you need to show me that you made the graph. Okay, so I hope that helps. Of course, if you have any questions about anything, please don't hesitate. Reach out to me, send me an email, come visit with me. I'm here to help you.